Ever wonder why B vitamin supplementation makes you feel worse, like overstimulated or agitated or irritable or just more anxious? If that's the question that you are wondering why with your fatigue, then this video is going to help you understand the exact reason. So let's talk about that. So let's say you're fatigued, you're exhausted, you're burnt out, and you're looking for a protocol, whether it's lifestyle, whether it's your diet or supplements. And a lot of the times it's very supplement heavy, and you're taking these B vitamins because you found out perhaps that you have B vitamin deficiencies, or you genetically you have an MTHFR or a problem with your B12, and then you take these B vitamins and you feel awful. Well, let's explain why. So there's this concept of overmethylation and undermethylation. And I think that that concept has become too simplistic. It doesn't consider all of the variables that happen in the environment, like inflammatory challenges or having problems with ATP production, that can really make, or a lot of histamines, that can really make your B vitamins, and whether you're undermethylator or overmethylator, more confusing. And especially if you're not feeling good with these B vitamins. So I'm going to give you a couple of take-home points and action steps and strategies on what you can do to solve the mystery. So first, let's explain an undermethylator. So an undermethylator tends to not have enough methyl groups. Methyl group being a CH3, that's not really important. Just think about it as it's a sandbag. I tell people it's a sandbag. And your body passes these sandbags like if you were fixing a flood, and you're a city of people that are passing sandbags to one another. If you don't have enough sandbags, you won't be able to make a dam, which won't be able to control the flood. It's kind of what happens in the body in a simplistic way. If you have MTHFR or MTR or MTRR, or things that don't allow you to make your methyl B12 or your methylcobalamin, that is thought of as a undermethylator. However, overmethylators are ones that once they make their SAMe, because that's what B12 and methylfolate work very hard to produce, once they make the end product, the SAMe, which is the biggest methyl donor in the body, once they make that, those methyl groups can't be utilized. So if you have a problem with 70% of methyl SAMe production goes towards repairing your muscle, and if you feel like your muscle's weak, or when you exercise you're a hard gainer, or you don't have a lot of muscle strength and you're losing your muscle, chances are you could be in this category, an overmethylator, because you're not using your SAMe to be able to repair the muscle. And one of the enzymes you would look at is GAMT. And if you have a couple polymorphisms on that one, that would be someone that would do very well with creatine. Anyways, whole other point. So other nutrients that use the SAMe, if they're polymorphic, like HNMT, you have histamine genes issues, or COMT, where you're not clearing out your estrogens or your dopamine effectively and you're overexcited, those would be considered overmethylators. However, it's not that simple, because when we have inflammation, when we have histamine issues, when we have histamine genes, we have a lot of stress, we have a lot of iron imbalances, that throws the over and under methylation talk out the window. So here's what I want you to do. There's a couple strategies. Number one, you can do a whole blood histamine test. It's really inexpensive. We started to add that to all our panels for the clients that we work with. And what that does is that shows, okay, if you have high histamine and you require methyl groups to clear histamine out, then it would stand to reason that you would have low methyl groups, right? High histamine needs methylation to clear it out. If methylation isn't taking place, then you have low methyl groups. You'll be an undermethylator in this example. And you could have the same symptoms as you would with high histamine. So I don't explain the histamine, or sorry, the over and under methylating symptoms because they're very, very similar. And I believe 100% of the time, it's not an over or under thing. It's an environmental thing, and you are demanding a lot more production of your methyl groups, and you are underutilizing them. And that's both an over and under methylation problem. But anyways, if you get a whole blood histamine test, and that test comes back high for histamine, you can consider yourself having challenges with clearing out histamine. So you would want to look at your histamine genes. You'd want to look at your methylation genes, MTHFR, things like MTR, MTRR. All of those gene SNPs would make it difficult, even MAT and making methionine, BHMT, PEMT, choline, trimethylglycine. If you want questions answered on that, shoot me a DM and I'll tell you how the genetic test works. But your genetic test can tell you these things. But that's the first test, because that could be really good. If you see that you have high histamines, chances are your methyl groups aren't working very well, or chances are you have too much methyl groups being depleted at the rate that you need to replete them to take care of histamine. And it, because you're not, histamine levels rise. So that's one test. But an easier test is a take-home test, and it's called the niacin challenge. And you can get 50 milligram niacin lozenges, where you would take it on an empty stomach. And niacin, what it does is it uses up or depletes your methyl groups. So if you are an under-methylator and you flush with 50 milligrams, where you have like a turning of red and just feeling hot, that's a flush. It's a niacin flush. And that's assumed to be because you have high histamine and that methyl group was just depleted and it caused a histamine flush. So if you get a flush on a 50 milligram niacin capsule, then you are an under-methylator. We need to support your methyl groups. As far as, let's say you didn't have a flush whatsoever at 50 milligrams, so you gotta assume that potentially you have high histamine groups, you can take another 50 milligram niacin capsule and see if you flush or not. A lot of people will not flush on that, and even they won't flush on 150 milligrams. And when that's the case, you know you have high methyl groups, right? Because you have enough methyl groups to take care of histamine that it doesn't cause you to flush. And even when you chomp up those methyl groups with a niacin challenge, methyl groups are around enough to not cause the levee to break and you to flush again. So those are high methyl groups. Those are the people that are gonna do very, very poorly with B vitamins, because you already have enough methyl groups around that aren't getting to places. And when that happens, that means you have a lot of other things to fix, mainly inflammation, because inflammation will really create a lot of havoc on not using your methyl groups. It will shut down a lot of enzymes, mainly having ATP issues, mitochondrial issues, overwhelm, because that will cause your methyl groups to not be utilized. And the other thing is ATP is required for a lot of reactions to make SAMe. And if you're not making SAMe because you don't have an ingredient that's necessary, in this case ATP, that's gonna cause you to have extra methyl groups around. Even if you have MTHFR or perhaps you have high methyl groups in one area, low methyl groups in another area, it's all speculation. But the point is, you can use the histamine challenge as a way to get really useful information. And so what do you do once you do, and the other last test, the third test, what I would recommend is it's by Doctor's Data, and it's a methylation profile. So you can look at your ratio of methionine to SAMe. If that's a high methionine, low SAMe ratio, you know you have maybe genetic challenges, problems with hydroxyl inflammation radicals, problems with producing ATP, maybe having a magnesium deficiency. That would be a huge reason why. Or if you have a SAM to SA ratio that is a very low ratio, then that's where you could have, if you have a lot of SA and not a lot of SAM, so that would be a low ratio, then again, your methylation is not working effectively. And that's where we can do some targeted approaches. So I just wanted to raise that question for people that have challenges with B vitamins. More than likely, doesn't necessarily mean you're an over-methylator per se. You can be, but chances are you have the perfect storm brewing in your body where you're not utilizing your methyl groups. You could have some gene SNPs that make it hard to produce methyl groups, and you could have some gene SNPs that makes it hard to utilize methyl groups. And making things much worse is if you have a high histamine burden, if you have a high glutamate burden, if you have inflammation in your body, if you have a lot of stressors and your ATP is depleted, and you have micronutrient deficiencies and you're not absorbing magnesium, or your magnesium is depleted, you are going to have a lot of challenges, and perhaps B vitamins are just going to make more unused methyl groups, creating an overstimulated state in your body. I hope that's really helpful for you. DM me if you have any specific questions on that.